Carrie? Carrie?
Hey, Kyle.
I found it.
Welcome to my little paradise in Elliot County.
Wow, this is fantastic out here.
I always said I wanted a place you had to get lost to find.
Well, as you can see, I'm being socially responsible, but this is very hot. Is it okay? Are we safe?
I think you're all right, Kyle.
Thanks. Fantastic. Well, I was told you had something for me to sample out here as far as a beverage. Is that true?
I do. We're getting ready to bottle some of my homemade apple wine. Would you like to help and try some?
I'm down. Let's do it.
Well, Kyle, here you go. This is a batch of our homemade apple wine. We call it AppleAtCha.
Fantastic. AppleAtCha. I like that. You know, this is great. Well, if you could help me load that in a car, I'll be on my way.
Well, not so fast, Kyle. I thought maybe I could pour you a nice cool glass after you help me bottle it.
Is there some science involved in this?
There is a little bit of science.
All right, I'm down for some science.
Come well, here. We started this batch last fall.
How many apples do you get on your trees, like, in a season?
I'd say we have 5 mature apple trees, so usually we get about 5 or 6 bushels.
So you can do 2 bushels for one of these?
Well, 1 bushel per 5 gallons.
Then what, you just throw them in this thing, or you gotta put them in a blender? I mean, how does that, what's the process?
Well,
there?
First you have to cut out the cores of the apples, so you cut out the core and the seeds, and apples have a lot of natural yeast if you leave the peels on. So typically you just cut them into large chunks and put them in a mesh bag, and you mix 5 gallons of water with 10 pounds of sugar and your 40 pounds of apples, and you let that kind of bubble and ferment for about a week, and then you strain out all that leftover fruit and put it in here. We put the 5 gallons of water in and we will cover it with plastic and put the lid on and just kind of let that bubble and ferment for about a week.
So you don't cook it, you just stick it all in there and let it sit.
Put it all in there together, just the raw fruit and the sugar, and mix it up. After about a month, we will switch the carboys. You know, you put it into another one. It's called racking the wine. When you move it from one to the other and you leave some of that sediment on the bottom.
Okay.
And then we do that at month 1, month 3, month 6, and then usually around month 9, I think it's ready to go to bottle.
Well, let's see what this bottling's all about. If you need my help, I'm happy to direct,
sure.
You know, and watch you do it.
First and most important step is sanitizing all of your equipment, including sanitizing your bottles and your workplace, as well as your hands. Next, pull off the airlock here, and the airlock is what makes sure we end up with wine instead of vinegar because it keeps the air out. So we're gonna go ahead and take that out. What I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna test the alcohol content of our apple wine with this fancy tool called a hydrometer. And it goes into the wine, and it will tell us kind of what our alcohol content is. All right, and then next, what we're gonna do is use this fancy tool to get the wine flowing out of the bottle and into our individual bottles, right?
Carrie, don't spill it.
There you go, Kyle.
Oh, that's fantastic. It smells good, too.
I'll give you credit for helping to make it.
That's good, yeah.
Yeah, here, I'll get you another bottle ready, Kyle. I told you I was going to put you to work.
Hey, this is great. This is really a very pretty wine.
Like, it turned out really nice. I thought you could use a break and we might sample some.
Oh, absolutely. It smells good. It's got some legs to it. Look at that.
Yeah.
This is legit. And it's clear.
It looks really nice.
It does. Wow.
See if it tastes as good.
Good for you. Let's try this out. And until next time,
we'll see you downstream.